everybody here is living a dream playing Pac-10 football.
Another Saturday, another day. It's time to roll.
On game day, it's the greatest thing. All the practice and everything, it's all worth it.
Begins the day after last season, in the weight room, on the practice field, through spring ball and into summer. When the season arrives some 240 days later, the work put in during the offseason has some 3.5 months to prove its worth. During the 2003 season, I turned the camera on my own team in the attempt to capture the last minute battles occurring within each player's mind. I knew pressure, anxiety, or haunting past would play a role, but I was unsure as to exactly what my camera would catch.
Are we ready? Are we ready?
That excitement, that enthusiasm, that emotion. Okay? You can't bottle it. It's unique. It's unique to this team. It's unique to this group. Okay? You know this team. I know this team. That we're going to play. Understand something. They're going to talk. They're going to yak. You know it. I know it. So what? Who cares? All right? All that is wasted breath on their part. After a play is over, kicker kicks a returnable ball a majority of the time. Our calls this week, middle, right, and left. Tomorrow, right now, as it stands in the depth, 44 different players are scheduled to play in the kicking game tomorrow. And maybe more, because there's some backups that might come into the game. That's just different guys that are starting now in the six teams that have an opportunity to make a difference in tomorrow's game. Tomorrow, at some point or another, if your name's called and you have the opportunity, take advantage of it. Step up. Represent. Represent you, your family, your teammates, your position group. Let's come together tomorrow in a common cause and go kick some ass. SD on the ready. Ready!
SD!
Guys, first off, we've had a great week of preparation. I'm very impressed and pleased with the way we have prepared and practiced this week. I want to go over some of the keys to victory tomorrow. Okay? Pressure the passer. Okay? When he starts throwing the ball up in the secondary, make the plays on the football. When we make those interceptions, everyone else rally. Play snap the whistle, let's get in front, let's take one back to the house. Wide receivers, you guys should be licking your chops. They think that they can play bump and run every single down on wide receivers. Don't let it happen. When the ball's up there, it's our ball. Period. Whatever it takes to get it, you get it. Our football. And more than anything, guys, have a passion and a fury. Okay? Whoever said that we're sick and tired of hearing about the, you know, records and all that shit, that means nothing. We control the football game tomorrow. Let's make sure that we're not sleeping. Okay? After every possession, offense, defense, special team, whatever it is, we're on the field. We have got to stay into the game mentally. We have to stay focused. Okay? Understand what's going on that way.
Tight end.
Cheers,
Dennis.
Pack 10 killers on set! Set!
Pack 10 killers!
Are you nervous for tomorrow?
Not yet. Actually, it's just a pumped up feeling, you know? Mm-hmm. Just, you know, every day, like, going by, like, in practice, all you're thinking about is the game. Everything you're preparing for, you know, is for the game. And then you get to the meetings, and you meet, and you do all this stuff, and you listen to everybody talk, and everybody else has something to say, some kind of input. And you just want to go out and play, you know, right now, like right after the meeting, you just want to go and play because it's all that's on your mind. Well, luckily, we're blessed with the movie we get to watch, if the system ever works, which it probably won't. You can cut that part out if you don't like it. Besides that, I'm just eating my hamburger, listening to my roommate Giesel complain.
Yeah, tell me about your pregame, your biggest fear.
Never thought about this before.
Me getting injured.
Like a serious injury.
A number of different injuries.
Knee or neck thing, probably.
Not playing the game, especially when you're just hurt.
Breaking something or tearing something.
Come down with some horrible, disgusting flu.
Shoot, that's real. That's easy for any running back. That's fumbling the ball. That's real easy. As a ball carrier, you're entrusted with the football. That's the most important thing in the football on the field. And so if you're fumbling it, you know, that's a momentum turn. You know, the other team gets the ball back. They're all hype. They have a better chance of scoring because they're trying to punch in an opportunity. That's the biggest fear. And plus in our system, Coach Teffer said, you fumble the ball, you're done. You're sitting, basically.
What do you think?
That shit ain't true.
What's the biggest fear?
My biggest fear? Fumbling the ball, like he said. But if you fumble the motherfucker, he's still gonna play. If you start.
What about injury?
Playing the sport that we do, you have no time for it. If you out there and you thinking about injury, man, you're gonna be very hesitant. You're not gonna be giving it your all. You're not gonna be the player that you can be. Injuries are part of the territory of the game, you know. It does happen, and everybody who takes that field knows there's a chance of you not being able to walk off that field. That's the price you pay, you know. But as long as you play hard, from snap to whistle, you give it all, you have a rare chance of really getting seriously injured.
Do you do anything specific the night before the game to calm down?
I eat. I get my stomach full. Drink a lot of Gatorades, chips. That might not be the healthiest thing, but
you know. And piss everywhere besides inside the toilet. Piss everywhere besides inside the toilet. I gotta wear sandals to go in the motherfucking bathroom.
You don't hear me.
Hey, you gotta stay in your rooms, right?
Ain't nothing else. Anything
about the game plan for tomorrow? I need to go over.
No.
Now listen to me. We have a 7:30 wake up. 8:30 is breakfast, our pregame meal. So make sure that you guys are ready to go.
I'm ready to go right now. If Arizona's out when I feel right now.
Hey, you gotta stay in your rooms now.
I ain't going nowhere.
Okay.
Hey, coach.
Sleep.
I can't go down and get ice.
Nope.
Go get it right now. Hey. Don't wait till the last second.
I'm about to.
I'm checking you now. No, put that on hold. Get your ice so that way you don't have to go in and out. Get some clothes on. Don't you represent the Universal?
I'm a handsome young man, coach.
Hey, Joe. You're on university time. Okay, you come out. If you don't have your sweats.
I'm about to just put that on the shirt, coach.
Okay.
Hey, Coach Z. You got something to say to the camera?
Nope.
12:08.
Hey, Tom.
Yep.
Need some ice.
Nobody care about you, man.
Nice big head ass special, man.
Cop, ice.
Big head ass nigga.
Put your shirt on.
Number 40, man. He ain't talking about nothing.
You can't be scared. If you're scared going into the game, you're obviously not very confident. And if you're not confident, you're not going to win. So you got to be confident going out there on the field and go out and have fun and just execute.
Do you get stressed before games?
No. Nah. Trying to just stay loose and have fun. It's just a game, no matter how you look at it, you know? We have all these meetings and we stay in this hotel, but it's a game.
Do you do anything the night before the games to calm yourself or try to focus yourself?
No, just hang out with my friends and try and laugh and stay loose. Just, joke around a little bit, especially the night before because, you know, it's not that serious yet.
I just visualize positive things happening to me. Positive reinforcement of things that could happen, visualization, I think really helps. When you get in those situations, you've already gone through them in your mind mentally, so just comes second nature.
What kind of positive things do you visualize?
Just making a good throw, doing what I'm supposed to do, making a right call, making a good throw, a guy catches it for a touchdown, or just third and long, making a throw at a spot, a certain spot, just making good decisions.
I visualize myself making that great catch or making that block to spring a teammate, coming through the gap and blocking a punt. And then I visualize myself, running off the field after the game and just having that great feeling that, we just won a game.
It takes me a while to wake up. I'm not really a morning person. So it takes me a little while to get up. I get dressed. I'm relaxed. I'm calm. I go get something to eat. I make sure I eat a lot. I don't want to be hungry. When I'm in the middle of the game, I don't want to have to worry about things like that. So I make sure I eat big.
That Christ makes it untrue. Let's pray. Father, thank you so much for the gospel. Pray, God, that these guys would play with magnificent passion today. Because you rescued them from the wrath of God.
How does God play a role in centering? Great
focus today. It gives me a reason to play. Without giving honor to him and giving back what he gave to me, there wouldn't be a reason for me to play.
Father, make them quick today. Make them strong today. And most of all, cause them to have great fun today on the field. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
G7 Sarah
Vice James. Set right here.
Left. Okay, that's in the battery now.
9999999.
Good, there we go. Good. All right, here we go. Hands up, ready to go. 1, 2, 3. Good, nice shot. Good blitz right there. Good blitz. We got 12 personnel in the game. 12 personnel. Good job. There's our purple call right there. That's telling us what now, man. Purple call is telling us what. Work empty. Number one right there. There's the super stud. Right there.
Stick.
Husky. Husky was number one right there. If number one is right there, what are we playing, guys? Special. Good. So right now number one is there. What coverage are we in?
Husky.
Good. All right, here we go. Hands up, ready to go. 1, 2, 3.
Gonna stay Raven, will be right Tom. Right Tom.
Right Tom strong. 181, double pump run.
Lucky.
0-1. Even set. 290. 290.
Looking for this safety. tight end, and out the score. Marvin, just quick break.
Let's give it dominate on the set. Set!
Dominate!
Hey, listen up. Bus leaves at 9:55. Remember now, if it's wet out there today, wet ball mechanics. Secure the football. Play snap the whistle so we're in a position to come up with loose balls if the ball does get on the ground. Okay, snap the whistle. All right? Let's have some fun today, man. Have a great time. Let's go. Let's go. Get it right. Let's go. Yep.
Go do it. Go claim what's ours. Bears on go. Go!
Bears!
This is the better football team.
I just trying to go out and just have fun, play football, and be loose the whole time.
I know that this is just for fun.
It's just a pumped up feeling.
It's always nervousness. Everybody gets nervous. It doesn't make you less of a man or less of a person.
And that's why I do it, because it is fun.
You're scared going into a game. You're obviously not very confident.
You just want to go and play because it's all that's on your mind.
Very much prepared. Worked hard this whole week. We're very much prepared. Me personally, I'm prepared. Just keeping my head straight.
So you'll be excited tomorrow?
Very excited. Southern Miss comes into town. Another Saturday, another day. It's time to roll.
Start my focus pretty early and get up and get in the shower, just relax, start thinking about, you know, the game and putting those positive pictures in my head, and then I like to put some choice music on, some slow jams, you know, some John Mayer, that kind of stuff, some Bebo Norman. Not many people heard about Bebo.
When I get to the stadium, that's when the juices really get flowing. That's when I get excited. I see the name on the back of my jersey, and I think, okay, you know, That's your name up there. That means you're here to do something. And I sit in front of my locker and I pull up the program and I look through the program and I see, you know, all the other great players who have done this before. And I really, really get excited. I get inspired almost. And I suit up and I make sure everything is in the right place and fits good and it's comfortable. And I strap up the pads nice and tight, and I look at myself in the mirror and I can't help but smile.
Guys pretty much stick to themselves and focus in their own way. You know, during the week people are joking around and you know, just having fun with each other. The guys got their headphones on, or guys just focused, you know, getting dressed, doing their own thing, and everybody kind of gives each other space.
Everybody's got their own thing. You see some guys with their music, and they're rocking out, and some guys are pumping the rap, and some guys are quiet, and you're in there, and you're suiting up, and you look around the room. It's like everybody's got their own thing, but you're gonna come together in about 20 minutes. You're gonna go on that field and you're gonna play together.
Just because you get hyped up before a game and just because you start yelling, that doesn't mean that that's gonna make you play better. You know, if you're the type of guy that has to be still and be quiet and visualize and think about what you have going on and think about what's gonna happen to you or whatever it is that's gonna happen. If you're that type of guy, then be that guy. Don't get out of your game based on what everybody else is doing.
The night before the SC game, when we had our final team break, when we're all gathering up, you just feel the electricity, you just feel the excitement, and I've never felt that before another game. You just knew, just in your heart, you just had that gut feeling that this game is ours, we're gonna win it, simple as that.
I feel the master.
I feel him.
Y'all ready? They ready. Well, come on. Well, come on. Y'all ready? They ready. We ready. We ready. Come on. We ready. We ready.
My nigga over here, number 6, I'll take it to the hood.
Alright, we're at 1 minute. Woo! 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, let's go!
Let's do it!
Know what we gotta do?
I'll go back to the movie.
he's at 250. 250.
Face is still up,
fly around, Lord God, and just be the sparks of this fire today, Lord God. Lord Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen.
Nothing's going through my mind. I don't know, right before the game, my mind kind of just gets cleared and stop thinking about everything. Before the game, I don't even know my opponent, who they are. I'm up to that point, it's just kind of blank. It's just a nice time where I just get ready and don't think about anything.
They got our killers on, got three ass in the ground. They will not hook you up, but so don't hook them up, baby.
The coin toss, what we'll do is we'll prefer, we want to kick toward the tent, so we're defending the scoreboard, because that's the way it runs ball. You're going to kick it out of the end zone, you're going to stop, and you're going to have to punt into the wind. And then you will be good for the win. So we're going to defer.
Okay.
Obviously, if they win, they defer. And that's a choice for you. Okay, so we want to defend the scoreboard. Defense, we're going to defer, we're going to kick the ball out of the end zone, we're going to stop them, make them punt into the wind.
Go!
but we gotta have a killer instinct. You guys understand that? A freaking killer instinct.
All right, still Banjo Sally. The only difference is free safety. It's declared Banjo. All right, so Sam, what does that mean? If the back comes out your side, we get the back. Got it. All right.
That ball's in the air. Go and get it. It's yours. No one else. Go get the ball. All right. We got the ball first. We got a march down score.
If the backers are really starting to play downhill, which is easy freaking deal, you just get your eyes up, right? You should see the whole damn thing. Start the double, man. Start. Oh shit! Boom.
Get your lather up. Be ready to go. All right. We take their heart right from the start. Take their heart from the start. Don't wait.
Here we go, we're ready to march this thing. Play in, play out, let's get going.
Let's go, let's go! It's time to bust them in their motherfucking mouth!
Let's go!
Play after motherfucking play! Let's go!
But no one ever doubted the outcome. Absolutely not. Saw it in your eye.
Guys, awesome job. 324 yards. Woo! Yeah! First time over 300 yards rushing in 11 years. Awesome job.
Yeah, listen up.
Hey, first off, congratulations. Awesome victory. That is the greatest margin of victory ever at Cal. In a packed in here. Nice job. You guys have worked your tail off. Okay? Two bowl representatives right over here from the insight.com. That's what it's all about, man. Okay? One more week. One more week.
It ain't finished,
my man. Man, I'm so proud of you guys. You guys are unbelievable. After the first half, defense, awesome job.
Yeah.
Keep them out of the end zone. Nice job. Hey, what great belief we have in one another to come out in the second half and understand we're going to get this thing done.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, tribute to you guys. You guys have worked your butts off. Very, very proud of you guys. Let's have seniors off defense come up here. Pictures with it, you're welcome to. Okay? We gotta sing our song.
You know it! You tell the story! You tell the whole damn world this is bear territory! You know it! You tell the story! You tell the whole damn world this is bear territory! You know it! You tell the story! You tell the whole damn world this is bear territory!
Make sure everybody's at the banquet. Let's send our seniors off right.
Hey, what about drinking some beer?
We'll talk about schedule on Monday. Just come to the banquet tomorrow. We will talk. We don't know which bowl it is, but we're going bowling.
Tried to swim again, put me down to pull my knee. clear that team success isn't bred through every individual triumphing in their personal struggles, but rather through a team succeeding in overcoming the concept of the individual and uniting as one. And, in the end, that's exactly what we did.
When you run as hard.